Hello everyone, today I'm going to be building a Slack clone using React, Tailwind and Firebase from scratch. So our application is going to look like this. We're going to have a top menu on the top side, a side menu. We're going to be able to change channels, write messages, and the authentication when we log in, we're going to see it works with Google Authentication. So basically, we click and we just log in with our Google account. So we're going to do it from scratch. And let's start by creating a create React app. We're using TypeScript for the code. And let's get started. Okay, our UI, we're going to be building it with Tailwind. And Tailwind basically is a way of designing UIs using class names instead of CSS code. So you can see here, for example, how it works. The way in order to install this in React is basically very, very easy. Let's go and see the installation process here. This is what we just did. And what we're going to do now is we're going to do the installation of the Tailwind and the post CSS components that we need. I'm using Yarn instead of npm, but basically it's the same. Once the libraries are installed, we're going to use Krako in order to be able to inject the post CSS configuration without ejecting from the Create React App default configuration. So let's add the Krako. And once that is done, we should be able to go to our code. And I'm going to go to the package and change these three lines. And I'm going to put the Krako here. Okay. Once this is done, we need to do the Krako configuration. And once that is done, then we need to do the Tailwind CSS init. Okay, we have the Tailwind file, and basically it's this one. One small change that we're going to do is that we're going to do the purging here so that in production we have just the components that we are using and it will tresake the unused styles in production builds. The other thing that we need to do is we need to add the index CSS. We're going to delete the default one and we're just going to put the Tailwind commands. Okay, so we're ready from the Tailwind side. Next thing that we're going to do is these parts, the icons that you see here in the UI, we're going to use Material UI. So let's go and start that one. And in order to be able to do this kind of navigation, you can see that the channel changes, the URL changes. We're going to use React Router DOM for that. I'm not sure if this is going to create any problem, but I'm trying it anyway. Okay, so once this is done, let's go to the app CSS. I'm going to delete the default CSS and I'm just going to add my own definition, which is basically preventing over-scrolling of the application. So if you go to a web application, basically this is called over-scrolling and we don't want it in an application native way instead of a web application. So in order to do that, we just add these lines. And in order to make it also native, we want the root document, the root component to be 100% height. Okay, so once this is done, I'm going to add the Firebase as a library and I'm going to add Firebase file here. Okay, so basically this is the Firebase configuration, which you can find it in the Firebase application. So if I go to my console, you can go to the, I think it's projects. I will select the Slack clone, and it's project settings, and down below here in the config you can find this Firebase configuration. And with this we can initialize the application. Here we're adding the Firestore, which is a real-time database, and we're adding the authentication with Google Auth provider, and we're exporting those. So next thing that we're going to do is we're going to use it directly so that we can display the messages and see how that works. So let's create a chat, and here, okay, let me fix this one, and this one should be here. Okay, so first of all, let's start the application. You should see it. Okay, here basically what we do is we create a list, create a local variable, which is messages, and the function in order to change it. Okay, let me show you first this one. So if we go to the application, I can remove this, and you can see that this is being updated on the fly. And if I add a hello, for example, here, but I add a class name with a background of green, you will see that this is being added. So this means that the Tailwind is working correctly. So I'm going to remove this part, and I'm just going to add here the chat that we just created. And you will see that when this compiles, okay, it finished. You can see now that these messages are coming from Firebase. So in the Firestore database here, we have a collection of channels, and for each channel we have, for example, the general channel, we have a collection of messages, and inside here we have each one of those messages, and these are the messages that we see here on this screen right now. And the nice part with Firestore is that these messages are, because it's a real-time database, whenever there is a change in Firestore, for example, I can go and change the, let's select the, yeah, for example. Okay, yeah. You can see that the yeah, it changed it to yeah. Okay. And probably you can see it better if I put it like this. You can see that it changes directly because it listens to the changes of this database and it triggers the changes to the components. And this is done very, very simply because we have this part here. And the DB is the DB of the Firebase, the collection of the channels, the channel ID, we have selected a specific one because we don't have a way to configure it yet. And here we have the collection of messages ordered by timestamp. And here we just update the list of messages that are here. And in this component, basically we iterate each of those messages and we display the message. So these are the messages. Let's go and build the skeleton of the application so that we can have a little bit of design first. And then we're going to fill in each one of those components. So the skeleton, we're going to put it in a file that is called home, and then we're going to display it. Instead of displaying the chat, we're going to display the home here. And this already creates a little bit of design of the application. So if you see here, these are very, very similar. So the only thing that we are missing is the components inside of those parts. So let's go and design these parts now. Let me explain a bit about the tailwind here. You can see that this just contains design for now, but this is very, very simple. Just add some kind of class names here, and these class names are creating the CSS part of the code. This is the local one, this is the remote one. Okay, so here, for example, if I change this to red, you can see that this component is being with the background red. Other type of tailwind components, basically, if I put here segment of title, you will see that this has some kind of padding, that if I remove it, it will go to the top left side. If I put the padding, it goes to more or less in the middle. Probably this also could be item center. This is a lot better. Okay, so let's go and fill in each one of those components. Let's go and go create the top menu first. So I'm creating the components. I like to create them with a plugin that's called ES7. So basically you do like something like this, and it auto-generates the code for the placeholder, let's say, for the function. Okay, so we have the top menu. Let's go and take this part, and let's go put it here. And here now we can just put top menu. And this would give me more or less the same thing. Okay, perfect. So now what we want is we want to create the, let's add the components inside here. So first of all, we need to add some arrows, arrow back, which is the, this is the arrow back. Let's see if this compiles correctly. First time that we put the React Material UI, it takes some time, but once this is done, then it's a lot faster. Okay, apart from that, we have the arrow forward, the query builder, we have a search component, we have an input here, help outline, span with my name here, and let's put an avatar, which we're going to style it. Okay, we already have one of the icons. Let's add the rest of them. Okay, now we have all the components, but they are like put to the left, so let's go and design a little bit better. First of all, we're going to create a div that's flex here with flex grow. But in order to do that, we need to do here flex also. Okay, and we also need to add a flex here. Okay, that way we have created two components that they are flexing when we do this. So this way these icons are staying in the center. Okay, so apart from that, Let's do something else. I'm going to center the items. And I'm going to do SpaceX for text gray 400. Okay. And then we need these ones, we need to combine them. Right, create a PX4, some width, going to add a background. Okay, I'm going to round them a little bit, the border. I need them to be flex. I will add some border and some border color. Okay, and now in the input, I need to put transparent background, some small text, outline none, and width full. Okay. So the outline none, when I put it, it will remove this square box. Outline none, you can see now that this is the gun. Okay, and we can add also a placeholder. Search. Okay, that looks a lot better. Okay, and go to the side menu here. For the side menu, I'm going to create a different file, and let's go to the home page. I'm going to take this part is the side menu, and I'm going to create it over here. Okay, I need to add it again here. Okay, perfect. So let's go to the side menu. We need to create a side menu title. Which is this part. And the side menu options. Okay, so here in the side menu title, we need to add, let's add a name, which this is span. This could be H1, for example. And here we're going to add a button, no, an icon, expand more. Okay, but now we need this one to be flex auto items center, so that these are centered. And we're going to put them to the left side, okay. And now on the right side, we need to create a create button. Okay, but we're going to give it some border, round border, like this. Okay, so going to the side menu options, we're going to have two things down here. So if we go here, we can see these are the actions and these are the channels. So let's go and create these two, side menu actions and side menu channels. So the actions there are a lot of actions, so we're going to create side menu action. We're going to create a bunch of those. And then here we're going to create for each one of those a div. And here we can create, for example, this is the icon and this is the text that we want to put. Yeah, we need to do a return here. And the other one, we already have it. Okay, so now we have different side menu actions, but let's go and pass some variables here. So here we're going to do a side menu action props, and here we're going to put text, icon, text, and to. The to is string, the text is string, and the icon is any. And these are going to be defined also here, text 2, and this is the definition of this, the parameters that this function is receiving. So here now we can add the text, for example, and let's go and put here some examples. Icon, I'm going to put create, for example, that we already have it. Text hello and to slash, for example. Okay, so the text now is a variable. Let's go and put here the icon. Okay, now that we have the icon there also, and now this one needs to be a nav link. And this means that the two can be like this. A nav link is part of the React router DOM, and this means that whenever I click to this one, well, we cannot see it now, but the okay, we don't have a router, so we haven't defined the router yet in the app, so that's a good point. So if we go to the app, we need to have a router here. And inside the router we can put the home. So the router needs to be, just a second, the application, we have to create this import for the router to work. So basically the router is the browser router. Okay, so now we have different components. That's perfect. Let's go here, side menu, the icons. Now we need to define a little bit better the nav link. So I'm just going to add the nav link with some design. So here we define that the nav link has some specific class names, which we didn't have before. And whenever the nav link is active, which means that this menu, this root here is the one that we are actually located at, then it will activate these class names, and these are going to give this blue color. But we don't want to have the same link to all of those, so let's change that. I'm going to create these side menu actions. And I'm going to import the icons from here. Uh, Okay, now that we have the icons, we should have a better actions. Yeah, perfect. So if I click now, you can see that the active one is the one that is being blue and the rest are being darker. Okay, now let's go to the side menu channels, which is this part. So for that part, function side menu channels, we will need to know the channels first and then iterate on those. So let's go and do that. First of all, for the getting the channels, we will need the following. We will need to create a use effect that imports a DB from the Firebase, and it will write to a specific local state, which is the channels. This will not use yet, but we're going to import it anyway. And here we define that whenever we get the channels, whenever there is a change in the channels, then we're going to set the channels with these values. And these values, then we can use them here, and we can do like channels map channel. Channel is any, I think, for now. Here we have all the channels, so we have iterated on those, and let's go and style them a little bit. So I'm going to take and design them like this. We don't have the add, this is an icon, and we're missing the add channel, which we're going to add it later. Okay, so now we have these channels, but we're missing the top menu here. Let's call it toggle menu, and let's put it like this, toggle menu text channels. Interface toggle menu props, and we have text which is string, and then here we're going to return. We also need here the children, which children is basically everything that is inside that component, and this can be anything. And okay, more or less this is the same as before, but now we can add things on around this component here. Okay, so now we're going to define it like this. We're going to have the arrows, and we need to have open set open variable, which by default is going to be open, and then we're going to have a toggle hide function, which is basically a set open to the reverse. So now we have this toggle menu here, and whenever we click it, it should do the toggle hide. Yeah, we have defined the same. We need to do the reverse. Okay, so now whenever we click it, it reverses the open state. And it hides this because this, whenever it's not open, it will not show the children here. Okay, so we finished with the side menu. Next part is to do the chat, the main screen. So let's go to the chat. Here we just have the messages, but in the home page, if you remember, we have a little bit more stuff. So let's go and take this one, and I'm going to put inside the chat. So let's go put it here. And instead of chat, here should be like this. This one. Okay. Okay, I have duplicity because I didn't save it here. Okay, now it's the same. Okay, so here we have the chat top. Let's create the chat top. And in the chat top we have the channel name. We have add a topic or something, and we have an icon to the right corner. The icon is info outlined. Okay, perfect. Now we need to do a div here and separate this from the other. Okay, and now we should do just 1 second. This is basically the design, but we should keep channel name. This is fixed for now. Okay. Still we're missing the span here, which is the class name font light text small add the topic. Okay, and we're still missing something. Okay, we're missing a div here. It should go like this. Okay, that's better. And we can add a flex grow here. Okay, so that will put the icon to the right side. And that's it with the top menu. Ah, we are still missing the channel name. So we're going to put here the channel name like this, for example. Okay, now it is parameterized, but it's still static. We need to define it. The problem is that we are having the channel ID and we don't have the channel name yet. So let's create the channel from the channel ID. we're going to create a use effect here that whenever we enter here, we're going to have a variable which is channel, and we're going to define it whenever we enter in this component. But we're still missing the model, so let's create a model for it. And the model for the interface channel is basically, it has a string and that's it. Okay, now we have this, and now we have the channel here that we can pass it as variable down here. And this way we should be able to have a name. Okay, we're missing the name here. Okay, this might be empty. Okay, now we have hello. Okay, we're still missing the change. Yeah, it doesn't change because still the channel ID is always fixed here. So let's go and change that part. If we go to the app, we have the router for home, and here we have the chat. But we can add here a root where we can say that this component is under the channel ID path, and it should only appear when this is the root. So we can also add a switch here just in case that if there are more roots then it doesn't render more than one. Okay, so now we don't have, because we're missing this one. Okay, now perfect. So now we are in the general, we're still changing, but we don't see the change because we have this channel ID here, but we don't use it. So in order to use it, we need to use params. And with this, it should be possible to, yeah, we need to import it. Okay, now you can see we have tech here, and whenever I change it, it changes to the name of the channel. Okay, so what else? We have finished with this, we have finished. Let's go and design the chat messages. So for the chat messages, we have this part here. Okay, so one of the things that we see now is that the messages are being defined up here. So we don't have them down here. Let's go and move this part here, because these messages are not necessary on the top level. They are necessary for the component of the messages here. And the channel ID, we can use it. We can define it also here. Okay, so now this works. And now we can define better the messages. So for each message, I'm going to create a component, chat message. And here I'm going to pass a message, which is going to be a chat message props, interface, chat message props, message, and this is a message which we don't have it. Do we have it? Message? No, we don't have message yet. So let's create a message model. And the message model is the following. Okay, we have added the message. We need to import it. Okay, this is okay. Yeah, okay, it imported. And now we can do, we can take this and we can say this is a chat message and the message is MSG. And this is message. This is now a message list. And the chat message needs to return this part, for example. Okay. What's wrong now? Cannot find. No, this is an old message. I have changed this to a message. Compiled, now we have the messages, perfect, it works. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add some styling to those messages. We need the user color. So the user color basically is the way of getting a color depending on what's the username of the message. So for example, here you can see that the different different users have different color for their name. Okay, so that works also. The last part that we're missing is the input here. And in order to do that, let's go and take this part. And we're going to create a function setInput. And we're going to put this one here. Okay, now we're going to replace this with this one. And basically what we do now is we do the following. First of all, okay, let's forget about the user for now. Let's put here ABC. We need the channel ID. The channel is string. And then we need this icon. And we need the Firebase import, which should be up here. Okay, and I think we're only missing one thing, which is here we need to add the channel ID. It's not necessary to pass it because we can use the use params also for passing it, but that's another way to do it. Okay, so now this works, and if I write a message now, you can see that the message comes as ABCD, but this is not our user. We're going to need to do a login with our user. So in order to do the login, we're going to first create a state, a global state of the application, not just a local state as we did now, right now, but a global state so that we don't have to pass the user from component to component as we did here, for example, with a message. So in order to do that, we need to create a state provider. Let's go build that. So the state provider, basically, you just need to add this code. And once you have the state provider, then you can create a reducer for that application. So I'm going to create my reducer here. It should be pure TypeScript. Okay, so basically the reducer says my initial state is the user is null. The action types, I can have an action that is set user. And whenever I'm executing the reducer, I have the previous state and an action. The action contains the action type, and it also contains the action type, and it also contains the payload, which is, for example, the new user that we want to set. And whenever it returns the state of something that has been changed from an action, it's going to be the new state of that application. So if I do here a set user with a user with a new user, then it will change my state, and it will set the user instead of being null. It will be the user that I have configured. So in order to do that, we need to also create a login page, and the login page should be something like this. So I have defined here a use state for the I have taken the dispatch from the use state, and whenever someone is doing a sign in, it will do the authentication from Firebase. It will dispatch the user to the global state of the application, and then it will change to that specific URL, which is the general topic, which is this one. And if not, it will catch and send an alert, display an alert to the message, the screen. Okay, so this is the HTML, and if I refresh now, okay, it doesn't do anything because I haven't connected yet, and I need to go to my app, and I will just do the following. I'm using the state, taking the user from there. If there is no user, then it should display the login. Otherwise, it should display the home page. So if I save this, it doesn't find the history, it says no. Okay, no, it doesn't have the, I need to inject the state provider here in my index file. So I'm going to do the state provider. Initial state reducer, and now I have a state for my application, and if I refresh, I have the login screen. If I click OK, continue, then it goes to my authentication in Google. And once that is done, then I can go inside. If I type hello, it still shows ABCD, but now we can go to the chat and we can change the user to the one that we have in our state. And then here we can have user.displayName, and we can also add the photo URL. And if this is imported, now we should be able to see the correct user writing messages. Okay, so now this is my username that is taking from the Google authentication. I can do the same on the my top menu. Here I had my static name, but I can also put user display name. I can also put here my user photo URL. And here I just need to do this line. And with this, I should be able to have my user here. So here you can see now my user. And the application is done. We're not missing anything else. If I open a second one, you should be able to see that these two screens, they are changing messages. Hello. And hi there, myself. Okay. So the last part that we are missing is how to deploy this. And in order to deploy it, it's very, very simple. Firebase init. You need to probably do a Firebase login before. Do hosting, use existing project, choose the project, put build to where you want the Firebase to be built, and then put yes for a single page app. And when you do now yarn build, the yarn build, basically it will build the application for production in the build directory. And since we configured Firebase hosting to take the build directory, when we do Firebase deploy, it will deploy it in our site with the contents of the build directory from locally. So let's wait for the production build to be built from yarn, and then we're going to deploy it to Firebase. And once this is done, then we are all finished. Next time I'm going to try to do the same thing, but instead of using Firebase, I'm going to do it with Supabase, which is an alternative of Firebase, an open source alternative. It uses Postgres from behind, and the idea is to use the Supabase that they are hosting themselves, and then go to a local instance of Supabase, probably inside the Kubernetes environment. And that's the idea of how we're going to continue with the live streaming. If you like the idea, then please follow. And see you next time. But before that, let's finish our deployment. Okay, deployment is finished. Build is finished. Now we're going to deploy. Okay, the deploy is finished, and now we can just use the deployed version as before. And voila, everything works okay. Thank you, and see you next time.